Nearly 2 years ago, Mike Lebecki and Corey Richards went to the bottom of the planet to scale a mountain face in Antarctica. What they found, yes, breathtaking scenery, but also blinding winds, sudden snowstorms, 2,000-foot rock face called Bertha's Tower. You can check out their adventure at the Jack Singer Concert Hall. We have details on that in a few seconds, but first we're chatting with Mike and Corey this morning. Thank you so much for coming in, guys. First question off the top is why? Why go all the way to Antarctica when we have, you know, the Rocky Mountains here and, you know, we have the Himalayas, you know, in Asia and that type of thing? Why go to the far south?
Well, as an obsessed climber, an addicted climber, you know, it's the most remote area you can go climbing. I mean, it's about 2,500 miles from any major city. So
okay.
It's having that feeling of being remote without rescue possibility, it's pretty special.
And daunting, I would imagine. I mean, not only for your safety, but if equipment fails or that type of thing, there's no help.
Yeah, it adds an extra element of you know, mystery. I mean, to borrow one of Mike's words, but I think that's sort of at the heart of all great adventure. You go out without the knowledge or without the security of being able to be rescued, and that's a big deal. You know, it's self-reliance, and I think that's sort of the height. I mean, even in the Himalaya these days, you see rescue as a very viable possibility.
Sure.
When something goes wrong.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Now, Mike, tell us, because I mean, you went to do this. I mean. Setting up base camp for you guys was even an ordeal, right? Just because of the extreme conditions, right?
Yeah, you know, when you go to Antarctica, you expect to be cold.
Sure.
And so, but there's a beauty in being cold. But the big deal there was the wind, called katabatic winds, 100-mile-an-hour winds trying
wow.
to scour and basically ferociously destroy your life. And so
okay.
that's the biggest challenge.
Well, how do you survive, though? I mean, because you'd have to melt your own water.
Correct.
You'd have to, yeah. I would imagine you're... Like, I mean, you do have to go to the washroom at some point. It would be cold.
No,
sure.
When you're down there, you just shut it off. For
well,
two
and we'll call it the washroom, but imagine when you're, you know, in
yeah.
Antarctica, there's an Antarctic Treaty.
Okay.
And so you have to bring everything out with you.
Really?
We're talking everything.
Everything.
Like it's a point across.
So. Okay. Pack it in.
Yeah,
pack
you want
it
to
out,
leave
right?
that the most pristine continent pristine.
Sure,
yeah.
Sure. No kidding. Okay. And so how did you guys get the energy then? Because I'm just wondering how you guys got the energy to do all of this.
Well, physically you get the energy by eating a lot of calories.
Okay.
Because it's just like living here, right? I used to live in Canmore, and I remember being extremely cold and going out and trying to exercise, going ice climbing, things like that. All you could do to actually maintain is just consume as many calories as possible. So we
yeah.
take a lot of food down specifically for that reason. A lot of butter.
No low-fat meals, right?
No, that's no.
And, you know, you can't force to do something like this. You have to love it.
Sure.
And so it's an easy, when you love something like that, it's organic enthusiasm. You're excited to go do this. So you have the energy. It's not, you go down there for fun, for
yeah.
joy, for what you love to do.
Talk about some of the special moments for you guys during your trip. How about you, Corey, first? Some of the special moments, because it must be worthwhile to see this part of the world.
You know, a lot of the special moments for me are sort of when everything's stripped away. One of the most special was when the plane that dropped us off in this area took off, you know, and then all of a sudden it's just dead silent, and you realize how remote you are. There's no contrails above you, you know, you're not looking up and seeing planes. There's
sure.
nothing. There's no light pollution. There's nothing. It's just, and anytime you harness that moment of, oh my God, we are so, so isolated,
yeah.
that really, I think, for me, it makes me come alive, you know?
How about you, Mike? Anything stand out?
Yeah, definitely. There's a lot of things, of course, but, you know, the friendships down there.
Sure.
And so when you get down into a place like that, it's kind of like a short-term marriage, and you hand over your life and the trust, and, you know, just the bonds that you make among your partners. And Corey and I, we didn't know each other before we
oh,
left.
Oh, really?
We
okay.
came together for experience, for my experience going down to explore and climb, his as a photographer for National Geographic. And
yeah.
that can be a dangerous situation if you don't know each other. But we ended up being really close friends. And so that was really special.
And that yeah. must be something you guys talk about at the Jack Singer, right, when you're explaining
absolutely.
To people.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, we really get into that because I think a lot of people tend to think that it's just about adventure, but I think it's so much more about the relationships and the friendships that you make.
Cool. And there you go. So Mike and Corey are speaking. There's a student show today at the Jack Singer Concert Hall. It's about 10:15 this morning. We have links on our website, breakfasttelevision.ca. Thank you both for coming in.
Yeah, pleasure.
Good luck on your next adventures, wherever they take
yeah.
you.
Nice to be here.
Thanks so much. Yeah. Cheers.